Okay, good afternoon everyone. I welcome you to my presentation. Today I would like to talk about my research and the title, Determination of Vitamin B6 and Vitamin C in Aqueous Solution Using FTIR ATR in Mid-Infrared Spectroscopy with Variable Selection Methods. My name is Meinilwita Yulia. I am the Master of Course student in the first year. I have divided my presentation into four sections. They are introduction, objective, result of recent experiment, and finally is conclusion. Now let's start with introduction. As we know, vitamin has important function for our health. Unfortunately, we cannot produce some of vitamin, for example, vitamin B6 and vitamin C by ourselves. So we need other source for vitamin intake. And fresh fruits and vegetables are main source of vitamin B and C. Many soft drinks also contain vitamin B6 and vitamin C as additional ingredients. Many conventional methods has been conducted to determine the concentration of vitamin C, but the conventional method has some limitation. For example, titrimetry method is a wasting time, and then produce chemical waste, for example, iodine and starch, and need high skill. So we need the better and simpler method than conventional method. Using spectroscopic method, we can measure the sample faster, simpler, but we need to ensure the consistency and accuracy of the measurement. Therefore, the objective of my study is to establish simple and accurate spectroscopic measurement of vitamin B6 and vitamin C in aqueous solution using FTIR-ATR in mid-infrared region. Next is the material and method in my experiment. This is the chemical structure of the... This is the chemical structure of vitamin B6 or pyridoxine hydrochloride, and I have measured 21 samples of vitamin B6 solution, including water. And in this process, I dissolved the vitamin B6 powder into the distilled water, shaking it until all of the vitamin B6 powder dissolved completely. And let's move to the method of my experiment. In my experiment, I use this spectrometer from Bruker using ATR terahertz spectroscopy in mid-infrared region, I mean. In this measurement, infrared source coming to the surface of the diamond prism and generate evanescent wave here. And then the absorbance spectra of the sample were recorded by the detector. In the measurement, I used the range of measurement between 375 to 4000 per centimeter with 64 number scanning and 2 per centimeter of resolution. Next, move to the result of my experiment. This is the typical spectra of vitamin B6 in aqueous solution in the low, middle, and high concentration of vitamin B6 in the aqueous solution. So, from this graph, we can see that there are several vibration modes here between 900 to 1800 per centimeter of wave number. And we can see too that this phenomena is adhered to Beer's law, which said that the absorbance and concentration are linearly correlated. Next, this is a very interesting result, I think. The vitamin C and vitamin B6 is different in chemical structure. And then from this graph, we can see the typical spectra of vitamin B6 and vitamin C in aqueous solution. They have the same concentration at around 18%. But as we can see, the fundamental vibration mode here is different. However, in the main fundamental of water at around 1640 per centimeter, the vibration mode is the same between vitamin C and vitamin B6. So looking this graph, we believe we can predict we can analyze this difference between vitamin B and vitamin C use principal component analysis or PCA. This is the result of principal component analysis or PCA. The main goal of principal component analysis is to transform the data in such a way that a new coordinate system is formed with maximum variance. So you can see a new coordinate system, and then we can see from this graph that there are a difference between vitamin B6 and vitamin C in aqueous solution in mid-infrared region. Using full spectrum of PLS, we developed the calibration model of vitamin B6 in original spectra in mid-infrared. And from this graph, we can see that the result was good because the fitness between actual vitamin B6 and predicted vitamin B6 is good with R square very close to 1. Let's move to the validation model. To evaluate the calibration model, we need validation model to ensure the accuracy of the measurement. From this graph, we can see that the result of the calibration model using validation model, the result is very good with high ratio prediction to deviation and high range error ratio. So we can apply this model to determine vitamin C and vitamin B6 in aqueous solution, and next in the future maybe we can apply to determine vitamin in juice in the real juice sample, I hope. But in the first maybe I think we should to measure the simple mixture between vitamin B6 and vitamin C. In conclusion, the typical spectra of vitamin C and B6 is different in mid-infrared region, especially in the range 900 to 1800 per centimeter. And then a quantitative analysis by applying PLS regression is also possible to predict vitamin B6 concentration in aqueous solution. And for next plane, I want to determine what bone fibrillation is causing to absorbance peak of vitamin C and vitamin B6, and I will apply spectra preprocessing for vitamin B6, and then I will acquire spectra of mixture vitamin C and vitamin B6, and finally I want to measure vitamin C in real juice sample, for example orange juice, strawberry juice, and so on. Okay, that's all my presentation today. Thank you very much for listening.
Okay. Any question? Wheel number 900 to 1800 is already reported another paper about
vitamin B6 determination. Because I searched for reference about the vitamin B6 determination, and difficult to find it.
Yeah, would you show us that graph? You enlarged some 900 to 1800 difference. Ah, this one. It looks proportional. Even 2400 to 33,000, also, something.
But peak, we cannot find peak in the average.
Just a minute, maybe a little bit mixed up. I thought when I saw this one, just mixed up, then this is just enlarged this part.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought this is 0.3 absorbance, and this peak was 20 something.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that, but that is just enlarged. You'd better just make a sample.
Okay, thank you.
Any other comment or suggestion? Yes,
please. I think this is important to you to improve your presentation. First is, you often say Fayette's model. Actually, maybe the appropriate word is not Fayette's model, but Fayette's test. Because actually we need some test methods to evaluate your model. So, not. And then the second one is, I think also it's important to think about the detection limit of your model, your system. I think maybe in the very few small amount of vitamin B will be something. So it's better also to show us the detection limit of your system. I think the result for zero amount of vitamin B is very high deviation. But I think later you can show us the deviation in each, for example, in very low and very high. I think in very low percentage, the deficit will be very big because the deficit limits will be.
Okay, thank you for your suggestion.
Anyone else? Okay. Right, thank you very much.